Hello, good morning students. Today we are going to start a lesson. It's NCERT CBSE 10th class, first chapter, real numbers. Okay, real numbers. Just to understand the concept of the real numbers, first I am going to explain all in detail what is the meaning of the real numbers and what are the types of the numbers. Okay. Students, let us say real numbers. What is the meaning of real numbers? Real numbers means, it means that the numbers which exist on the earth. So many different kinds of the numbers are there. In that, all that numbers includes real numbers. So let us see that in real numbers, I have divided here in two types, mainly with decimal numbers and without decimal numbers. Okay. With decimal numbers, we are going to study about next. First, let us see the numbers without the decimal numbers. Because these numbers are already, you are very familiar, because you have studied from since first standard, you are studying the numbers. Okay, let us see the numbers means without decimal numbers. Friends, you can see here, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, goes on. See, what I have written here, these numbers are called integers. Okay, again in integers we can divide, this we can take, understanding? Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay, these numbers are called as negative integers. You can name them as a negative integers. Okay, now here this is 0. This 0 is called a 0 integer. Now, on the right side, we can see that plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, infinity. Okay. And now, these numbers are called positive integers. Okay. Always, you have to remember that. You have learned that in lower classes. What you have learned? When you put a number line, okay, when you put a number line in the middle, we mark as a 0, and left side of your, you have to see the left side of your, and what numbers are coming in left side, all that are negative integers, and right side they are positive integers, and middle 0, it is a 0 integer. Now in this again we have so many different types of the numbers. That is we call as a natural numbers. Natural numbers. Let us see what are the natural numbers. Already you know that numbers, the counting numbers, we can say for the natural numbers, we can say that counting numbers. Okay, the numbers which are countable. When I will say you to count the numbers, you will start 1, 2, 3 like this. Okay. These numbers which are we are counting from the 1, these numbers are called natural numbers. So for that reason, we will say it as a counting numbers. Okay. Now let us see one more, that is whole numbers. Here, for these numbers we can say as a counting numbers. Okay. This is whole numbers. If you include 0, if you include 0 to this, then we can say it as a whole numbers. For example, whole numbers are starting from 0, means we have to include 0 to that. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, we can say infinity. Okay, this is infinity. Means it is continuous process. And next one is the prime numbers is there. And here, I'll write here prime numbers. Okay. And composite numbers. Composite numbers and co-prime numbers. See, we can say these all numbers, because natural numbers, whole numbers, prime numbers, these we can say as a same family. We can use as a same family. Okay, so prime numbers, composite numbers and co-prime numbers, all the numbers comes in this section. We can say it as a without decimal numbers. Okay. Now let us see this side with decimal numbers. Okay, students, listen this carefully, because what I taught you till here, this already you know, because you have learned here in lower classes. Now this also you have learned, but this is important for your chapter real numbers. Okay, let us see with decimal numbers. Here one example I have given, 1.5. This example, we can say it is a terminating number. For example, if you divide any number, you will get 1.5. Means there is no continuous, it is completed. This is called terminate. And let us see the second example here. 1.12121212. And continuous, dot, 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 tick, 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 we can say. Okay. This here we can say that it is non-terminating, means it is non-ending. Here terminate means it ends, it is ending. Here it is non-terminating. Non-terminating means it is continuous, it is not ending. You have to remember that. And one more thing happen in this, the numbers are repeated here. After getting 1.12, again we are getting 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, like this. The numbers here, we have to observe that the numbers are repeating. The numbers are repeating. Okay? This is the second type, non-terminating, and the numbers are repeating. The numbers are repeating here. Okay. Now let us see next example. 1.21356748. Okay. This is the example. Here also the numbers is, we can say this one. Okay. It is continuous, it is not closed. And this is not non-terminating. Okay. Now, and it is non-repeating. Here it is repeating the numbers. But here you can observe that the numbers are not repeating. Okay, this you have to observe. The numbers are not repeating. Okay. Now, this is about a little bit about the numbers with decimal numbers and without decimal numbers. Okay. You can make the video pause and you can write this one. Now I am going to give some examples regarding the, see, which numbers we can say here. These numbers we can say as a rational numbers. Okay. And this type, last one, if you can see here, this we can say as irrational numbers. Okay, this is regarding rational and irrational numbers. Now I am going to give some examples of the rational numbers and irrational numbers. Okay, let us see about that. Till that, if you want to write down, we can make your audio pause and you can write. So now a little bit we are going to study about the rational and the irrational numbers. I will not go detail, because in 1.3 we are going to detail study about this one, the irrational and the rational. So, jab 1.3 study karenge, tab rational aur irrational ke baare mein separate 15 aur nahi to 20 minute ka ek video banaunga. Tab jo cheez yahan likha hai rational aur irrational ka, wo aap log dekh sakte hain. Now, let us see the rational aur irrational. See, the rational numbers would be always in the form of the P by Q. Okay? Where we can see that Q is not equal to 0. Always this thing we have to remember. When the number is rational, that is in the form of the P by Q. and Q is not equal to 0. Okay, now this we have to remember. And in irrational numbers, for irrational numbers we can give example as root p. Here p is nothing but prime number. Already you are very familiar about the prime number. This is here root p means prime number. So let us see examples where prime numbers we can give: root 2 and root 3, root 5, root 7 and root 11. Okay, these are the some of the examples of the irrational numbers. And for irrational number we can give pi also, because already we know that pi value is 22/7. Okay, when you divide this one, you can will get that 3.142 means it is continuous, means the numbers are not repeating and it is non-terminating. That you have to think. Okay, that you have to keep in that mind. Then irrational numbers are, the numbers should be, it should be non-repeating and it should be continuous, means it should be non-terminating also. That you have to remember. Okay, this is regarding a little bit information about the rational and the irrational numbers. Okay, and we can say that as these irrational numbers that cannot be represented as a simple fraction. Okay, in simple fractions we cannot represent this one. Okay, this is regarding the real numbers. Okay friends, now it's very important, we are going to start that the in real numbers exercise 1.1. I'm going to take textbook of NCERT 10th syllabus. Okay, here we are going to start first exercise NCERT 10th syllabus first exercise 1.1. we are going to start here. In this I'm going to take textbook also, because here you can see that first one is very important, is Euclid's division algorithm is there. Euclid's division algorithm, that you have to think. Euclid's division algorithm is nothing but here we can see it as some in textbook they have given lemma also. Lemma is nothing but it is a theorem. Lemma is nothing but it is a theorem. Okay, let us see. Euclid's division algorithm. In this Euclid's division algorithm, we'll explain that dividend, we can say dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Okay, this is the formula of the Euclid's division algorithm. On this basis we are going to solve the sums of exercise 1.1. here we can see that the dividend, already we know that, and dividend is always equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. See here, when you are going to divide any number, okay, it is dividend will be here and divisor because always we will take a big number as a dividend, so we have to take here a dividend and here as a divisor. After taking this one, we are getting here quotient and after dividing, the remaining number is called as remainder. Already you know that this is called remainder. Okay, this is just for your basic information. Now regarding this one, We are going to start the exercise 1.1. What is the question paper in exercise 1.1? First question is use Euclid's division algorithm. We have to use the Euclid's division algorithm, and with the help of that, we have to find the HCF. What we are going to find here? We are going to find the HCF. We are going to find the HCF by using Euclid's division algorithm. We have to find out the HCF. Okay, we have to find out the HCF of 135 and 225. They are given here two numbers. With the help of the Euclid's algorithm division method, we have to find out the HCF. Let you know that HCF, highest common factor. In lower classes, you have to read this one with the different methods, but we are going to learn here with the help of the Euclid's division algorithm theorem. Okay, now this is the formula of the Euclid's division lemma, okay, theorem. A equals to b cube plus r. Here, A, like I told you, it is a dividend. It is always equals to divisor into that quotient, divisor into quotient plus remainder. Here we have to one more thing we have to remember. 0 is always here, remainder is always greater than or equal to 0. Remainder, we may get remainder 0 and we may get remainder 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So for that reason we can say that 0 is always smaller than this remainder, and sometimes it is equal, smaller or equal to r, r means remainder, and here it is always greater than the quotient. Okay, this thing we have to remember. Now in this question 135 and 225, 135 and 225, which number is a greater number? We have to mention that. Okay, so 225 is greater than 135. Okay, now in the division, in rough you can do this one, 225 divided by 135. Okay, now if you take 135 twos are, it is bigger than the 225, so we can take 135 ones are 135. Here 5 minus 5 we will get 0. 2 is small, so we have to take as a 12. 12 minus 3, it becomes 9. Carry 1 and it becomes 0. Okay, now we got here this one remainder. Now we can write here 225 is equals to, we have taken here 225 because here the dividend is 225 and it is equals to 135. And into 135 into 1 we have to do, plus remainder. How much remainder? 90. This is the first step. Clear? Okay. Now, next one is we are going to divide with the 135, because 135, while comparing the 90 and 135, we can see that 135 is a big number. So, we can write here 135. Okay, can you see it? When you return, you are going to divide 90 divided by 135. So here also we can take 90 ones are 90, because if you take 90 twos are, again it will becomes greater number. So 5 minus 0, 5, 13 minus 9, 4, carry 1, 0. Okay, now we got here remainder 45. And this number we have to take here. Before going to write, do the division, this step we have to remember and we have to write. 135 is equals to 90 into 1 plus how much remainder? 45. This is the second step. Now next one is 90. Okay, now divide it. Is it there? 90 is there in 45 table. We can see that 45 ones are 45, 45 twos are 90. So that now we got remainder 0. Okay. Now when you got remainder 0, till that you can stop that. If you get remainder 0, Now write here the step. 45 into 2 plus remainder is 0. Okay, therefore then you can write the HCF of 135 and 225 is equals to 45. Okay, this is how to find the HCF with the help of the Euclid's division algorithm. Okay, so if you want to write down this one, you can pause the video and you can write down. Okay, now friends, we are going to, first sum is understood. Now let us see second sum. It is 196 and 38,220. Okay, little bit big number so that you can understand clearly. Okay, let us see in this also, we have to compare the numbers and we have to write which is big number. 38,220 is greater than 196. So the big number you have to take, you can divide here 38,220 divided by 196. Okay. Now let us say about the 196. Here we can take 3 digits, 382. So if you take 196 twos are, it is bigger than this one, because again it will came 196 196, nearly 400. So we can take 196 ones are 196. Okay, now here 12 minus 6 we get 6, carry 1, 18 minus 10 8, carry 1, 1. 186 is left, so 186 is smaller than 196, so we can take this 2 here down. Now the number is big, so that in 196 table we have to do, okay, 196 nines are, we can take, I have given in rough, okay, 196 into 9 we can do, 196 into 9 we will get 1764. So after subtracting this one, 12 minus 4 8, everyone. Here 16 minus 7 becomes 9. 16 minus 7 becomes 9. Okay, and carry 1, 8 minus 8, 0, 0. Now we got only 98. So one more 0 is left here. We can take 0 down. Okay, now 196. In 196. 196 fives are, you can take 196 fives are 980. So after subtracting, you got remainder 0. So again, not need to do division next steps. Okay, here because students we got here 0. So directly you can write here 38,220 is equals to 196. Into 195 plus remainder 00. Okay, this is the only step in this, and you can write here therefore HCF of 196 and 38,220 is how much? 196. Now friends, we got here answer 196. Now question number 3 is there, that is 867 and 225. This is for you try this at home. Okay, because I have solved their question number in first and second I have solved, so that you can try this at home. Okay, now we are going to question number 2. Students, now in exercise 1.1, question number 2, main question 2, the question is, show that any positive odd integer is of the form 6 cubed plus 1 or 6 cubed plus 3 or 6 cube plus 5, where q is some integer. They have given here q is some integer. Okay friends, we have to show that in this question any positive odd integer, it is positive and it should be odd integer, and it should be in the form of 6 cube plus 1, 6 cube plus 3 and 6 cube plus 5. It should be in that form. Now let us see this one. Let A be any positive integer we can take. Any positive integer. Okay. Well, we don't know that in integer. So we have to take, let A be any positive integer. And they have given here B is equal to 6. So that in the form of A is equal to BQ plus R we can write. Where this you have to remember, where A 0 is smaller than or equal to R. R means here A reminder. And this is always, B is always greater than remainder. Okay friends, if B is equal to R, if B is equal to 6 they have given here, if B is equal to 6, then A is equal to, we can write 6 cube plus R. Here we have to find out the possibility of the R, means possibility of the remainder. Whenever you are going to divide this one, what are the possibilities of the R? Possibilities of the remainders. Sir, what are the possibilities in, if you divide that any number from the 6, what may the remainder, we have to think. The remainder may be 0, the remainder may be 1, the remainder may be 2, the remainder may be 3, the remainder may be 4, the remainder may be 5. Okay? Always you have to remember that if B is equal to 6, then the remainder should be always less than that 6. So from 0 to 5, we can say that the 0 to 5, they are the possible remainders of this number. Okay? Now, this I think you have understood. Now let us see what are the possibilities. Now, therefore, we can write that 6 cube plus 0, because the possibility is 0, no? 6 cube plus 0 we can write, or 6 cube plus 1 we can write, or 6 cube plus 2 we can write, or 6 cube plus 3 we can write, or 6 cube plus 4 we can write, or 6 cube plus 5. These are the possibilities of the remainder. These are the only possibilities. Okay. Now students, let us see that they are told positive odd integers. Positive odd integers. Okay. Now positive odd integers are, what are the positive odd integers in this? Now we have written here 6 cube plus 0, 6 cube plus 1, 6 cube plus 2, 6 cube plus 3, 6 cube plus 4, 6 cube plus 5. In this, what are the odd positive integers? Okay, let us see. Here 6 cube plus 1 and 6 cube plus 3 and 6 cube plus 5. These are the odd number, possible odd numbers. 6 cube plus 1, 6 cube plus 3, 6 cube plus 5. These are the odd numbers. Okay. These are the odd numbers. Now, I can write here on the website. Okay friends, now I think till here you have understood what I have told. Now we are discussing about only positive or odd integers. They are so we can write at the end. Hence, it is proved. So we have down. I don't have place, so I have written here. You can write that down. So now, how it came? Just we can check. If you want to write well this one, you can make your mobile pause and you can write. Okay. Let us see. Let us check here. Just rough. Okay, students. See here. We got here 6 cube plus 0 plus 1. Okay, 6 cube. You can see here we can write, instead of this one, we can write 6 into 1 plus 1. How much we will get? 6 1 is 6 plus 1, 7. Okay, next one we got 6 cube plus 3. So, this we can write in the form of the 6 into 2. Plus 3, 6 to the 12, 12 plus 3, 15. So, the numbers we are getting here, these numbers should be odd. So, hence it is proved. This is to make you understand. Understood? Okay. This is in the form of 6 cube. To make you understand, I have told this one that it is not necessary to write in the exams, this one. Okay. This is only for you to check whether it is right or wrong. Okay, students? Okay, friends, now we are going to see question number 3. I will read the question. Okay, can you see here? The question is, an army of contingent of 616 members. Okay, 616 members are there. In the 616 members, it is to march band, any army band of 32 members in a parade, okay, where they have to march 32 members in a parade. The two groups are to march in the same number of the columns. What is the maximum number of the columns in which they can march? So the army is there. You may see that the soldiers, they will do march first. You may see that in Republic Day and Independence Day, you are going to do the march first. Okay, you are standing in three, that rows and columns. There, this way, here we have to understand. Okay, this is the column. Okay, and this is the rows you can. Okay, they have to, total 616 members are there, and they have to march in the column of the 32 members in the parade. Okay, the two groups are in the march the same number of the columns. They have to march in the same number of the columns. Okay, let us say, actually the question is very simple. Nothing to do here. If you find the HCF of 616 and 32, you will get answer. Let us see that. See here, and HCF of 616 and 32. Okay, friends, here we can see that I will give the maximum number of the columns, which we will give the maximum number of the columns we have to find out. Okay, let us see by the Euclid's division lemma. Euclid's division lemma. Lemma is nothing but theorem here. Okay, by that theorem we have to find out in this 616 is greater than 32. Okay, now how you did the HCF in first sum, first min, like that you can do here. 616 divided by 32, can write. Okay, 616 is equals to, let us say how much you will get here. 32 2's are, it is 64, so we can take 32 1's are 32, 11 minus 2 9, carry 1 and 2. So we can take here 6. So directly I will take here 32 nines, it is the highest number. 32 nines we can take. 32 nines are, we will get here 288. Okay. Friends, 16 minus 8, we will get here 8. Everyone, 9 minus 9, 0, 0. Okay, now remainder is 8. So again, we can take here 32. In 8 table, it is easily divisible, so we can take 8 fours are 32. Now remainder is 0. And now we have to write the steps. 32 into 19 plus remainder, how much we got here? Remainder first one 8, that we can take here. Now next one is we have taken here 32 as a dividend, and we have divided from 8 into 4 plus 0. Okay, therefore how much answer? HF we got 8. Now we can write here the army can march in 8 columns. Okay, here the army, they can march in 8 columns. Is it clear? Say total 616 members are there. Okay, in that 32 members, they have to march in column. Okay, if they want to make that 32 column, means in 8, the army can march in 8 columns. If you do that 8 columns completely, then they can stand properly to the parade. Okay, we will go for next question, that is question number 4. Okay, students, now we are going to see the question number 4. First, I'm going to read the question. Understand carefully. Use Euclid's division lemma to show that the square of any positive integer is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1 or some integer m. Let x be, and they have given hint here, x be any positive integer, and the form is 3q, 3q plus 1 and the 3q plus 2. Now square each of this, means we have to, that is the hint, we are going to in the sum. Okay, let a be any positive integer. Okay, we don't know that integer, so we can take here a is a positive integer. Okay, and b, they have given here in question, they have given 3. Now by Euclid's division lemma, Euclid's division lemma, A is equals to BQ plus R. This is the formula, always you have to remember. This also same. Okay, after this, A is equal to B, how much? B is 3. Instead of B, you can write here 3 Q plus R, because we don't know R, we have written. Okay, is it understood? Here A is equal to BQ plus R. This is Euclid's division lemma. And here A is equal to 3Q we have written, because 3 already we have here in question. The value they are given, B is 3. Okay, now first you have to find all the possible values. All the possible values of R. This 3 is there. In last time only we have discussed that. The 6 was there. We have taken remainder as a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, B is equal to 3. So what are the possible values of R? Possible values of R here are 0, 1, and 2. These are the 3 possible values when the integer is 0. Now, when R is equal to 0, A is equal to 3Q plus R. Instead of R, you can write here 0. Okay, is it understood? Because we have taken R as 0, when R is equal to 0, A is equal to 3Q plus R is there, but instead of R, we have to write 0. Okay, Now a is equal to 3q plus 0, we'll get our answer 3q. Okay, and in hint the question they have given about the square of any positive integer in question they have given. So you have to take here squaring on both sides. Okay, after squaring on both sides, what we will get? After squaring on both sides, we will get here a square 3 is q square. Okay, can you see? Okay, next I will write here a square and 3q square. Here a into a will get a square. Here 3 into 3, 9 q square. We got here 9q square. Now a square is equal to, a square is equal to 9q square. After that a square is equal to, we can write here 3 into bracket 3 q square. Can you write this one? Here in question they have given 3, for that reason I have divided this 3, because 3, if you take 3 as a common, what inside left? It left here 3 q square. So again if you multiply 3 into 3, again 3 3 is a 9 q square. This would be there. Okay. Now I think you can't see on the board. I will write here in the side. Okay, after this we can write a square is equal to 3 into 3 square. After this a square is equal to a square is equal to, we can write 3m, where m is some integer. Okay, students, is it understood? One more time I am going to explain here. Listen it carefully, because this is really very important. Okay, see here a is equal to bq plus r and a is equal to 3q plus r. Here all the possible values of the r are 0, 1 and 2, and when r is equal to 0 we have to take, when r is equal to 0 a is equal to 3q plus r and a is equal to 3q. And here squaring on both sides, because in question is there square of that, so we have to squaring on both sides. If they give cubing means in question you have to do the cubing on both sides. We have to do cube. Now we did here squaring on both sides, a to a a square, 3 into 3 9 q square, here a square. Now we split it into that 9, 3 taking as a common, and here 3q square left. Okay, after this next step is a square to the 3m. We can write, instead of this 3q we can write m, because in question they are given m is a some integer. Okay, I think it is understood. We can go for next step. One more step, that now r is equal to 0 is completed. Now let us see when r is equal to 1, let us see that. Okay, students, you can see here when r is equal to 0 is completed. Now when r is equal to 1, yeah, when r is equal to 1, a is equal to 3q plus 1 we have to take. Okay, because r is there, 3q plus 1. Again next step is squaring on same steps last we did, no? Squaring on both sides. What you will get? A square 3q square plus 1 square. Now a into a square 3q into 3q 9q square, 1 into 1 1. Okay, because if you multiply 1, always you will get 1. So instead of that, let us see that a square plus b square. Instead of doing this step, one more step we can do this one, because here also square is there, here also square. So what we can do, it is in the form of the a square plus b square. This is the form of the a plus b whole square. So that a square plus b square plus 2ab. This identities we have to remember always, because I think it came last year in 9th class you were studying about this one, identities. Okay, now let us see here a square as it is. Here 3q plus 1, it is in the form of a plus b whole square. Now a square is equals to, a square means 3q square plus b square means 1 square plus 2 into a means 3q plus b means 1. Okay, this is a square, this is b square, it is 2 into a into b. It is in the form. So you can see that clearly it is in the form of the a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay students, next, a square is equal to 3q square as it is, 3 into 3 we have to multiply, 3 threes are 9q square plus 1 into 1 we will get only 1 plus 2 threes are 6, 6 plus 1 2 into a into b, sorry, here it should be multiply, multiplication, 2 3 is 6, 6 into 1, 6, q, okay, we have here q, so we got here q, okay friends. Now let us see what is the next step. You can observe here, a square is equal to, we got here 9q square plus 1 plus 6q, okay. Now here we can write a square is equal to 3, you can take as a common, because we need 3 in this question, because you can remember the last step. If you take here 3 as a common, you can keep here 3q square plus here 2q plus 1. Is it clear, friends? Okay, see here, in this, listen here one more time, in this, because 9 is there, 6 is there, so we can take 3 common, because we need 3, because in the end they give 3q or 3q plus 1 and 3q plus 2, so we have taken as 3 as a common, and what left inside, 3q square plus 2q and 1 or 2, okay. After this one, what we can write, a square is equals to 3 plus 3m plus 1 we can write. Why? Because you can write here result, m is equals to 3q square plus 2q, and m is some integer, they are given in hint, some integer, m is some integer. Is it understood, friends? Because m is some integer, so we can write 3m plus 1, m means 3q square plus 2q. I have done. This is important, because directly if you write like this means the evaluator can't understand. So this is very important. Why you have taken m here? That you have to mention. Okay friends, this is the second step. Like this, one more time I have to do, r is equal to 2 we have to do now. Okay, let us see that. Is it clear? Tell her a bit. Okay, I will have this, and after that I will do when r is equal to 2. Okay friends, already we have completed when r is equal to 0, and when r is equal to 1 we have completed. Now this is last step, because when r is equal to 2, okay, here also we have to write 2 on the squaring on both sides. We have to do here, okay, a is equal to 3q plus 2. Try to squaring on both sides, a square 3q plus 2 square. Okay, it is also in the form of the a plus b whole square. the formula is a square plus b square plus 2ab. That thing we have to remember. Now let us see, a into a will get a square. Here a square, first we have to take a square, 3q into 3q. What answer you will get directly? One step you can write here, 3q square plus 2 square plus 2 into a into b. 2 into a means 3q into b means 2. Okay, and this is a square, this is b square, this is 2ab, 2 into a into b. Okay, now a square is equals to 9q square plus 3 into 3, 9 plus 2 square means it becomes 4, 2, 3, here. Next step is 2, 3 is 6 and 6, 2 is 12 cube. Okay, is it understood? Same, how you did in last step, no? Same step we did here. Now, let us see next. A square is equal to n q square plus 4 plus 12 q we got here. Now we can write here, a square is equal to 9q square plus 12q plus 4. One more step, to make it easier we have to write here one more step, because here it is in the equation. Okay, we have to write 9q square plus 12q plus 4. Okay, now let us see what we can do next. Here as it is we can write this one, 9q square plus 12q. Instead of 4, we can write here 3 plus 1, because we need 3. We know that 3 plus 1. Okay, so now a square is equals to, in this we can take 3 as a common, so write here 3 q square plus, because 3, 3 is a 9, 3, 4 is a 12, so 4 q we can write, okay, plus 3, 1 is a 3, okay, after bracket we have to write plus 1, remaining 1. Okay, now a square is equals to, we can write a 3m plus 1, because this we have taken as a m, we have to write here m is equals to 3q square plus 4q plus 1. Okay, we have to write this one. Okay students, is it understood? Now and then again we have to write here, hence it can be said that the square of any positive integers is either of the form 3m or 3m plus 1. Hence it is proved. Okay. Now you can make your video pause and you can write this one. Okay. This is one thing is very important here. We have to understand the concepts. Okay. And the next one, question number 5 is there. I am leaving that question to try at home to you. Just understand that concept and try that at home. And the next, we are going to do exercise 1.2 with the same methods. Okay, friends, students, if you want to continue this our YouTube channel, please subscribe my channel and take help of this. Okay students, thank you.